Sanford High School and Technical Center is a project that's about 10 years in the making. They put in applications for the Department of Education for funding with the goal of integrating career and technical education with traditional high school students. They did also have a severe population increase since their previous building was built, and their career and technical labs were vastly undersized. Sustainability for this client really started with a discussion about what their sustainable goals were. In this particular case, we had two clients, both the town of Sanford as well as the state of Maine, who was funding the project. There was a lot of discussions about initial cost, but I think that really grew into let's look at costs across a 30-year lifespan, and then we can make sustainable choices that don't necessarily have a huge investment up front, but that have an easy, clear payback that can easily be documented so the state can defend its taxpayer dollar use and the community can defend why they're doing what they're doing. So one of the key goals for sustainability for this client was selecting materials that not only benefited the building, but also benefited the community that it serves. For them, one of those materials was Jeunesse Block. By integrating Jeunesse Block into the exterior materials, it allowed them to not only showcase a material that was locally sourced and therefore sustainable to get to the site, but it also allowed the community to put themselves to work, to use local materials, local labor, and cycle funds from the project right back into their own community, which was something that they wanted to do from day one. One of the extremely unique things about Sanford is the full integrated approach to career and technical education in high school. For them, they wanted to reinvent themselves and say that every student, whether they're approaching college or whether they're approaching a career in the trades, had equal footing in this building.
The core of the student-centered design is that they made a decision to separate the school into four smaller learning communities or pathways. And there's arts and communications, health and human services, science and technology, and business and management. And the idea was that a student could take all of their academic classes in one of these smaller learning communities. And they could really focus on that area and develop a skill set in that area along with other like-minded students. It would really feel like a home in this smaller community. But it was really important to also make the distinctions seamless so that another student who wanted to take classes in a bunch of different areas could do so comfortably. Really key element to getting these pathways to work was the integration of the career and technical education programs with the traditional high school programs. You know, CTE has been doing this great hands-on learning and project-based learning for generations. And to integrate these programs in with the traditional high school programs, put them on the same footing so that they could really celebrate the different styles of learning and the different directions that people might go in within an area of study. So for example, the design, digital design, and video production CTE programs are in the same arts wing with pottery and painting and music and drama. So kids that are looking to pursue an arts area of study, whether they're a CTE student or a traditional high school student, are all in the same pathway. And then to sort of further enhance this pathway experience, we decentralize the student gathering area. So each one of these pathways has a hub or a pathway library in it. It's a place for students to gather and sort of build their own communities. The scale of the building was really the biggest challenge, how to make 2,200 students and staff feel at home in a 300,000 square foot facility. For the exterior of the building, we broke down the scale using regional vernacular and regional materials. As a plan, we separated these pathways in a very simple and intuitive way. There are all these great skylights and interior glass walls that really draws the natural light into the center of the building. There are these multicolored block walls that along with this color intensity that really pulls it all together. Each of the pathways has one of these colors, so the colors help with wayfinding. They give each of the pathways their own identity while still making it feel like part of a larger whole.
What really stood out to me in Sanford was Sanford's sense of community, and the two spaces in that building that really embody that are the Performing Arts Center and the Agora Stairwell. They've been able to bring in a ton of cultural events through the Performing Arts Center, and it's like kind of nothing else in the area. When you walk in, you really feel inspired to not only celebrate the arts and the performing arts, but maybe join them. And the Agora Staircase is something that has been booked by community events, school board events, student events, teacher events, all year long. The client really loves it, and it's one of our best, kind of our favorite, one of our favorite things to design.
Sanford High School came together very nicely because we have a full complement of engineers as part of an integrated design approach. We were also complemented by a full team of owners, including factions of the building committee, the superintendent's office, the state, and several subcommittees that focus on specific things like performing arts, aesthetic design, or sustainability. With the leadership and the guidance of that group, we were able to hit each of our goals as part of the project very well.
I really feel as though it's the kind of project that really gets to the heart of why we become architects. We really want to feel like we're empowering a change, really inspiring a group of students for generations.